might be camping, but I can hear you when you start to run, buddy.
Audio is one of the most important things in Call of Duty. So for all that is holy, please use dead silence. I know in that clip you just saw, I was able to hear the player with dead silence going, with covert sneakers on, and I was able to turn and kill them. But only the turbo nerds are going to be able to hear that, first off. And it's going to be within like really close range, like really close. You can only hear Deddy within about 10 feet, and they have to be sprinting. If they're moving, just like walking, you won't hear them, really. It's very, very, very quiet at that point. And I'm going to explain, okay? I'm going to go into a lot of detail today because I think this is probably one of the most important things in every Call of Duty game. It's important in every FPS game, frankly. Sound cues in every FPS, Rainbow Six, Counter-Strike, Call of Duty, Battlefield, whatever it is that you might be playing, sound plays an important part of it. I'm going to go over, first off, why. Well, I'm going to play the clip for you again first, and then I'm going to go over how I can hear it and the settings, and you'll see the rest of the game because there's a lot of sound horn that goes on even against dead silence players in that match. But if you're not a player that hears a lot, like you don't really think it's that important, I'm telling you it is. Just run it. It will help you get more kills. It will help you die less. Even if you don't think it's helping you that much, I promise you it is against the nerds. Okay, I promise. Now, we're gonna play the clip again. I'm gonna strip my audio, my voice audio, and I'm gonna play the game audio at normal audio range, like I think turn it up at like 10 decibels. And then I'm gonna actually play the specific part on when I hear the player. Because even though you have good audio settings or you have sound EQ, which I'll explain sound EQ in a minute, there are certain cues you have to listen for. So I'm gonna roll that clip again and let's see if you hear it. Now, the reason I wanted to play that is because even though you might have a nice headset, you might have a mixer, you might have sound EQ, which I'll explain that in a minute. If you don't know what that is, you'll see. If you don't know what you're trying to listen for, you still will not be able to get those kills. You need to know what you're trying to listen for and pick up the sound EQs. And that is just a simple one. That's just a player moving with dead silence. But there are a ton in Call of Duty, and they're different across every title. You know, people can hit grass and make a little shh noise. You with dead silence, it's a loud noise. You can pick it up easily. You can hear reloads of people, and if someone's going for a reload, you know you can push them at that time because they're not like their gun's not ready. You can hear for the click of a grenade, so you know when to push somebody. There are a lot of sound cues in the game, and if you know what to listen for, it will help you get kills. Now, besides understanding and knowing what to listen for, how do myself and other turbo nerds hear these people? Well, as I said, I do have a nice headset that does help. You don't have to have a very expensive one, by the way. I have used Astros over the years. I've used Turtle Beach X31s, which is like 14 years ago. I've used Turtle Beach X11s. I've used a $60 headset. I've used a $150 headset. It can work in either way. This one is more comfortable, which is why I wear it, but you don't need to spend $400 on a headset or anything. I have an Astro mix amp, which I do like. It does help, mainly for streaming, because I can balance my audio better, and because I can push audio from multiple sources to my headset, which is nice. Also, I have it set to tournament mode, which means if you know how to tinker with the sound EQ in there, it basically just makes the bass lower. It makes the treble higher, so you can hear footsteps or, you know, explosions are quieter, gunshots are a little quieter, but things like footsteps or a reload sound would be louder. So it just picks up little things like that. It's a little helpful, a little bit, not crazy. Also, you have your own game settings. You can go into your game audio here. I have home theater. Some people like bass boost, some people like headphones. These in general usually just have a higher bass, even though this is the highest bass, this is still higher than home theater. Home theater just has a very high dynamic range setting, it says, which tends to pick up the higher pitch stuff a bit better. To me. Some people like this stuff. It's kind of, you know, up to you. I prefer this. This helps me hear better. Additionally, the last thing, sound EQ. Oh man, this is a bad one. You're gonna hate me for this. I have a clip from the stream to explain sound EQ. Sound EQ is essentially called sound equalization. It's a Microsoft feature. It doesn't work for every headset and every audio source. It does work for some. It can be done on console, although I don't know how, but because it's a Microsoft application in Windows, Xbox is Microsoft. PlayStation, I think you're screwed. Sorry. But it sucks. It sucks to have this problem in the game. It is a PC advantage. I want to say this now. There are more controller players on PC than there are mouse and keyboard on PC. So this isn't like just, oh, I can't believe mouse and keyboard get this advantage as well. It's just a PC advantage. I would love if it wasn't a problem. Unfortunately, it is. And I don't know how they could fix it. But let's just roll a clip from the stream. You can see how much of a difference it makes. Okay. Is it OP? Maybe. Would I be fine? Here's the thing. I would be fine if they got rid of it. But everybody needs to fucking get rid of it. I'm not gonna turn it off and try to be prideful. Okay, fuck you. If it was gone for everybody, maybe. How do you do it? I'll show you really quick. It's pretty simple. Let me turn that off. So you right click on your sound settings on your PC. Open sound settings. Is that right? No. What is it? Is it the sound bar? Right click. The little speaker. Open, is it just sounds? I think it's just sounds. Yeah. And you right click sounds. So down here where your little speaker is, you right click it and you click sounds and you go sound. Then you go playback and you select your playback audio, which mine is through my capture card and it routes through my headset. And so the difference, I'm going to show you the difference too. You're going to be mind blown. You go to properties here, enhancements, and you turn on loudness equalization. And you can even customize it by changing the cutoff period. I do it one tick down. But like, here's an example. I'm going to bring the game back up for you guys. Let's see. Hold up. Where is the game? There it is. So I'm not changing the audio at all. Actually, I'll turn up the Elgato audio all the way for you. So you can hear the Elgato audio. Normally it's like negative 12 decibels. So this is normal audio for me. Okay. This is 100% audio. Now, if I turn it off. It's about, I don't know, 14 decibel difference, at least on my audio scale that I see. Okay. At least 10. That's the difference. And that's just on the menu settings. So it's very loud. Now, I don't hear everything the same that you're hearing. Obviously, you have audio turned down right now. I go negative 12 for you guys. And even on my side, I use my own mixer to change the audio for me, so I don't hear everything at super, super, super loud like settings. It's not just fucking cranked for me. So I have things balanced for myself as well. So loudness EQ, along with headsets, along with mixers, along with the game audio preset. I mean, people hear everything nowadays. Dead silence should counter 90% of players. It is extremely beneficial. Don't get me wrong. Just because all the stuff is out there and quite a few sweaty nerds take advantage of it, not everybody does. And even then, I still get killed from people close range with dead silence on. I don't always hear them. So it still works. It is always worth using in Search and Destroy. Always. Always, always, always. Sometimes, if you're going for a certain strategy, I understand not using it. Maybe like if you're looking at, I don't know, a certain jump up strat on like the boxes of Skid Row, you want climbing boots instead. Understandable. But almost always, you're best off just using dead silence. Please, please, for your sake and my sanity, so I don't have to see people not using it anymore, start using it. It'll help you out. It will help you. I'm trying to help you. Enjoy the rest of the video, though, with the actual game that this came from. I know this was a little bit weird one, but I figured I would try to put together a vid to understand or help you understand the sound in the game and hopefully be able to perform better because of it. So if you enjoy, consider liking and or subscribing, and let's get into the game finally.
Destroy it. Friendly UAV online. on to the next.
Yeah, right, she'll suck.
Y'all are the worst ride chillers I have ever encountered.
Bro, you guys are dog shit.
Just run into him a knife, baby.
Absolutely fucking.
Now we have a sword on, so that'll be easy.
Use the charges, blast the target. No mistakes.
This guy peaced out quick, didn't he?
Starting at Bravo. 1 minute remaining. Device in place. Countdown started. Our device was
secured. Oh, I figured the two guys out there would be watching it. Obviously, that was my mistake. My surprise face. I ran past this guy, by the way. In a corner, UAV on, red dot on the minimap, ran right past him. And now you know why they defused the bomb last round.
Set up a perimeter around the objective. Do not let them reach it.
That grenade was a bad one, shit. You might be camping, but I can hear you when you start to run, buddy. I will hear your dead silence when you're that close to me. Oh, should jump. Snapping on them? Well, I mean, first off, I heard him. Second off, he has to come up the stairs, so...
Finish the mission.
What are his options?
Standing by.
Shit.
On to the next.
That guy blended in. Until he started to move. Can you still have people that use covert sneakers? That's what I'm saying. That guy had covert sneakers. But if you full sprint around people when you're really close, and they have headsets like mine, and they're turned up, they're gonna hear you. They just are. They're gonna hear you.
Friendly UAV on station.
Copy. Advanced UAV establishing orbit. Scanning for hostiles.
So if you're loud, you're gonna be heard. Yeah, that's true. The Windows audio setting, sound EQ is what it's called, sound equalization. It makes quiet sounds loud.
1 minute remaining.
Well, that was a really fast game of absolute destruction.
The mission is complete.
And I have a settings video that shows it. Not everything can have sound EQ turned on it. But a lot of things can have sound EQ turned on. And before people say, oh, that's such a big advantage for PC, people do know how to turn sound EQ on for console as well. It does exist. It's a Microsoft application. Additionally, all the PC players have controllers plugged in. They're controller players on PC, and they also have sound EQ turned on. So they have it too. They have it too. Trust me, it's not just PC players. There are more controller players on PC than there are mouse and keyboard players on PC. So there are more controller kids using this than there are mouse and keyboard. Just keep that in mind.
Oh, shit.
For you. Oh my god, you scared me to death.
We're plotting at Alpha.
No one's watching flank at all, by the way. Guaranteed death. I'm not doing it. That guy just killed himself with a grenade. He threw a grenade down and then jumped into it. Good news, you can maple this now without killing yourself in this game. He saw me.
Hostile UAV in the area.
Trade me. Thank you. Here we go again. Three, two, one.
Enemy movement.
What?
Three, two, one. What were they doing there?
Oh, I missed my first
the
shot.
Gas nade
so
pissed
them
off. And since they had the UAV active and I was pushing forward, my only option was to W as hard as possible and then come back through it. And since the guy shot at me and missed from the top of the ladder, I had to just go down low. It was the only option. And then run into my gas grenade, hoping he would try to follow and then couldn't aim for a second. It was not a great route. I would not recommend it, but it worked out.
Behind you, teammate. Behind you. Yep.
Final minute. Round secure. On to the next. Copy. UAV is on station. Recon online.
There's a guy top A. Another one on bomb, A side. Nice. Good shot, bro. One. Nice, bro. Good shot.
Oh, shit. Literally.
Bottom,
one's not gonna spawn.
One to your right early. Bottom.
Only you remain. Finish the mission.
Oh, what do you called me out? Here. I missed horribly. Alright, I stopped using controller. Because I played Fortnite and it was bad on Fortnite. Controller was really bad on Fortnite early on.
Round secure. On to the
back spawn.
Like, I wish I liked it, but I just don't. Like, I wish